There are many ways of killing viruses and bacteria, but one way is using ultraviolet light.
Hi, Lucas. Thanks so much for joining. Where are you at the moment?
Thanks, Nico. Thank you very much for the invitation. I'm in Brazil. I brought the family from Monaco here, directly from the race in Marrakesh because of what is happening in the world.
How do you think things are going to progress? Because we're all seeing in the media there's this big debate between the president and everything. What do you expect for Brazil? Is it really a big disaster in the making for all the people who are having very low income, or what do you think?
Yes, we have two disasters. I think the first one, at the short term, is that these communities, the favelas, the slums in Brazil, they are tightly packed. Half of them, they don't have running water, so they cannot even like wash their hands with soap and water. And second, the recession. I'm doing pretty much three fronts on trying to help Brazil with this crisis. The first one is I try to raise money, but because the money I can raise, it's kind of limited. We try to focus on the communities that will have the worst impact for coronavirus, which is old people in public places. So we raised 150,000 reais, which is 150 minimum salaries here, which is it's not enough to buy ventilators and stuff, but it's enough to buy some basic hygiene and protection. So with this money, I asked my friend, which normally on a day-to-day business, he prints tailor-made insoles for shoes. I called him. We found an open source file for protection masks, for face shields, and he's now putting the 110 printers to print about 1,000 a day.
Here, meu amigo, Thomas de Harvard, ele é dono de uma empresa chamada Pés Sem Dor, mas nesse momento de crise, ele disponibilizou todas as impressoras 3D dele, 110 máquinas para imprimir, ó. Esse equipamento de proteção, essa máscara, esse face shield, com as normas da Anvisa, vocês podem ver, ó, já tem várias impressas aqui. E é isso aí, um exemplo de quem está se adaptando e ajudando a sociedade brasileira nessa guerra contra o coronavírus, né?
Isso aí, todo mundo junto, a gente consegue ganhar.
Valeu, obrigado para você que doou, obrigado para você que contribuiu, e vamos lá, juntos a gente vai vencer essa crise. Valeu!
I would like to talk to you about the third project that I'm involved, which is a bit more high-tech, and I know that you like that. There are many ways of killing viruses and bacteria, but one way is using ultraviolet light. A very fine spectrum of ultraviolet light kills virus and bacteria. It's a high-energy band of the ultraviolet light. It's already been used in hospitals, in some airline companies to sanitize the airplanes. And China has just started using in the public transportation unit. So basically you come with a super powerful ultraviolet C light, you switch it on and it kills everything. It kills even human cells because this light breaks down DNA. It's quite well known, it's not a new technology, but has never been used in public transportation. So what I'm doing personally this week, I bought all the materials and we are doing a pilot, almost like a supermarket cart with a lot of lights that we're gonna test in the subway of Brazil to decontaminate the public transportation in a much faster way, in a process that will take 30, 40, 50 minutes to do it manually with alcohol or a bleach. We're gonna be able to do it in 5 to 7 minutes. This pilot, this prototype of this light version, this light tower, and we're gonna test it next week.
Okay, awesome. So we look forward to hearing how it goes for you guys in Brazil, huh? I mean, that would be huge. That would be massive.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's just trying to lower the cost and improve the decontamination process a little bit and see if it can help anyhow to unload the stress on the public transportation services.